Breaking: Lunatic tries to run Trump off the road but was no match for Trump's beast mobile. President Donald Trump can't catch a break from the bitter, angry Never Trumpers. It has been over a year since he was elected President of the United States of America in a shocking defeat of Democrat candidate Hillary Clinton, and people are still mad about it. Can you believe people have held in this anger for over a year, even though their life has probably not changed one bit? This is madness, right? The angry Democratic and liberal madness continues. This week a man was arrested for trying to cut off the presidential motorcade. The motorcade was returning to Trump's Mar-a-Lago resort when Trump was done golfing with Tiger Woods. While the motorcade was on their way back, they experienced a bit of road rage from a man driving a red van. The driver tried to cut in between vehicles in the motorcade, but that wasn't happening. He was stopped and arrested by local police. The driver, as bitter as he was, then made numerous obscene gestures and screamed multiple expletives. Can you imagine being that angry over who was elected president? Obama was president for 8 years and people didn't flinch or bat an eye. Sure, people criticized him, but most Republicans and critics of Obama carried on with their life because not much changed for them on a daily basis. Well, you know, maybe we could come up with a list of things Obama did that no one liked. I believe that starts with healthcare and allowing men in the women's room, but that's another topic for another day. Let's watch the video coverage of the incident with the man in the van. If the man is angry about Trump being president, then he needs to relax. If he's angry that he was arrested, then he needs to realize what his actions were and why they were wrong. What if the disrespectful man had an explosive in the van? Here's more information directly from BizPack Review. An angry driver tried to cut into President Trump's motorcade and made obscene gestures after being pulled over by police. The scene unfolded Saturday as Trump was returning to Mar-a-Lago Resort in Palm Beach, Florida, after a round of golf. The incident is reminiscent of a similar episode earlier this month when a cyclist stalked Trump's motorcade and flipped the bird at the president. The latest incident underscores just how much extra work anti-Trumpers cause for the U.S. Secret Service and local police whenever the president goes anywhere. While Trump haters gleefully celebrate such confrontations, keep in mind that taxpayers foot the bill for all that extra security. A man in a red van attempted to cut into the motorcade. Local law enforcement pulled over the vehicle, where the driver made obscene gestures and screamed several expletives, according to a White House poll report. Is that any way to treat a president? Even if you don't like the president, you still can't cut into the motorcade. That's just common sense and a level of respect that Americans should have, regardless of who is in office. If Hillary Clinton was president and she drove down my street, I wouldn't cut her off. I'd be arrested. Is that worth it? Not at all. The people who risk getting arrested to do silly gestures like this need a lot of mental help. They are seriously angry at the world and they need to relax and realize things are going very well right now for most of America. Trump is doing a fine job. If his tax reform gets fixed, then we will all be happy. Let's be honest, folks. The GOP tax reform could be a bad choice towards middle-class married couples earning over $100,000 per family, which is not a lot if the family has kids. Many Americans fall into that category and they might get hit with a tax raise. Again, that's another topic for another day. You can research that on your own and make your own decision. The point is that Trump's doing well regardless of what the liberal, Democrat media tell you. They're so angry they can't even enjoy the fruits of the American labor. Or maybe they do because tax-paying middle-class citizens are constantly footing the bill for the welfare recipients and the socialists begging for freebies. Do anti-Trumpers realize that every time they do something absurd towards the president, that there might be a need for increased presidential security? Who pays for that? The taxpayers do. So in theory, every time a never-Trumper pulls an act of stupidity, it could essentially cost taxpayers money. Is that any way to treat your fellow Americans? Do they care? Some of them don't have jobs, so maybe they're not paying taxes anyway. Maybe they should grow up, stop being so angry, and enjoy this wonderful country like the rest of us.